Hello, we're Bob and Penny Lord. There are women that the Lord has allowed to shine like a star in the firmament. Because of the contributions of some of these women, they have changed the course of the history of the church. Catherine of Siena lived and died for the church. As we walk on the cobblestones Catherine walked and touch the wall she touched, we share in part the glory and love of Jesus and his mother as they spoke to and guided this saint in her journey of faith for the kingdom.
Catherine was born in 1347 into a large, wealthy family.
Catherine's parents built their huge home in the heart of the city on the street of the dyers. Their home included their dye works on the lower level and the rooms above where most of their children with their spouses, the family servants and dye workers lived and ate.
One day, Catherine and her brother were slowly returning from the country home of their married sister. Catherine loved and preferred the peaceful countryside to the bustling city. She paused on the hillside to look at the great Basilica of St. Dominic. She saw a vision which would affect and determine the rest of her life. Catherine saw Jesus seated on a throne, dressed in the white, gold-embroidered vestments of the Pope. On his head, he wore a papal tiara, which has been passed on for almost 2,000 years from Pope to Pope.
Standing beside him were the apostles, St. Paul and St. John the Evangelist, but he was not looking at them. Instead, his eyes were on Catherine. His love and smiling face filled her with a joy she'd never known before. He stepped toward her and blessed her with the sign of the cross. Her eyes fixed on him, she felt herself rising out of her body, being removed from the world around her, losing consciousness of her very self. There was such a magnetism going from Catherine to the Lord that although only 6 years old, she knew her childhood was over. Catherine reminds us of the children of Fatima, who after Our Lady touched their lives, their toys meant nothing to them.
Catherine, desiring virginity, turned to the Virgin of all virgins, our Blessed Mother, for guidance on how to put her son Jesus before all others. Who better than the Mother of God, whose yes brought her to the foot of the cross, could intercede so powerfully with our Lord and